I'd gone to Fairfield expecting to find you waiting for me. It was unreasonable, I can see that now. But imprisonment behind barbed wire does something queer to an active man. Well, that's my only excuse.
It seemed to me an adequate excuse.
Oh, poor Charles,
I whispered.
I was absolutely shattered,
continued Charles.
I went back to Brown's hotel where I'd taken a room. I was wretched and bitter and full of resentment, but I was too proud to give in. I made up my mind to forget you, as you had forgotten me. But it wasn't easy. I had no friends in London. Bob Loudon had gone home on leave to see his family. I was sleeping badly, so I went out at night and walked about the streets. One night I was nearly done for by a flying bomb. The blast bowled me over, and when I came to my senses, I saw that several houses had been completely wrecked. I helped the firemen to dig people out of the ruins. They were glad of another pair of hands. Some of the inhabitants had been killed, but we found two women in the cellar and got them out. We found a man pinned down by a beam of wood and released him. Sir, I was astonished. I'd never imagined such magnificent courage and fortitude as was shown by those people, who had lost their homes and all their possessions and had barely escaped with their lives. Their behaviour made me ashamed of myself. I decided to face my trouble with the same courage and to make plans for the future. I would go to Canada when the war was over and buy a farm. I would start a new life in a new country.
Charles hesitated for a few moments and then continued in a low voice.